Kemi, and welcome to another episode of the Kemi's Diaries. In case you're wondering, why am I like this? It's because I've received the shock of my life in recent times. Yesterday, was that correct English? I don't even know. I'm just saying nonsense. Donald Trump is the president-elect of the United States of America. Like this guy, this Trump Industries guy, Donald Trump, is the president of the United States. He's the president of the free world. He's the president of the most powerful country in the world. Wow. Like, it beats my imagination. I can't even express how he's doing me right now. But all I know is that Donald Trump is the president. And there are some things I've learned from all these election campaigns. You know, my last video, I was talking about what I've learned from the campaign. And at that time, I had no idea that I would be saying Donald Trump will be the president. I mean, I was already bringing out points of what I was saying, things I learned from the first female president of the world, of United States. But I received a lot of my life, and that was it. So there are five things I learned from this election, the results and everything. Now I'll say to you guys, so if you want to know these five things, please keep on watching. The first thing we should all remain know in all of this is that social media is not reality in any way. I know we've been hearing it time and time again that when someone is trying to bully you online, you should not mind the person. It's like a 2-year-old child just behind their computers doing anything. I never realized that the way it works so bad, the way it works so good too. Like when somebody's telling you Hillary Clinton is the best, Donald Trump is this, it works both ways. Like people who do not have liver, who do not have kidney, are the ones that begin to say things and do anything they like on social media, make people like me think that Hillary Clinton will win. It's so freaking annoying. Like social media, even though everybody is in it, the impression it gives, the way it makes people feel about people, is fake. It's not real. It's as if you are trying to live your life based on what you're seeing on social media. Maybe you checked up somebody, person is living the large life, and then you want to like bankrupt yourself for the bills. And my sister, run away from that, because social media is not reality. Like even the United States of America election has proven that. Like if it's by social media accounts, we say no. But because social media is not reality, social media doesn't always depict what is happening in real life. It's not equals to the real life. It's not the yardstick for saying something is going to happen or something is going to happen. That's how you see celebrities' pictures online and you begin to think, oh my God, they're in love. My brother and sister, 100% of the time, it's not true, because if it was less social media, Hillary Clinton would have won. Number two is that the world is not as open-minded as we thought they were. Like we used to think that we Africans were the ones that our minds were like, okay, we don't know anything. And then as I said, you start seeing people doing things that are strange. They cook in a strange way. That's another story of another day. But we try to make ourselves seem more American. And we are thinking, oh my God, the American people are open-minded. They are open-minded to gayism, same-sex marriage and all those things. But I never thought that they were not open-minded to a first female president. No shade, but I think that's one of the reasons why she didn't win, because there were some people, some ancient white people, who think a woman, like everybody thinks we are feminists, but the truth about it is deep down in our hearts, we all are not feminists. Most people are not feminists. They do not imagine themselves that a woman will lead them. So the world is not even open-minded. So Nigeria, we're even trying to save, at least we're trying. Even though when Taraba person win governor, we still move out. But the world is not open-minded. And I'm really, really disappointed that the world is not open-minded. Even though they were open-minded to allow a black man rule them. And even though there were so many obstructions on the way, let's just leave that for another day for another day. But I never thought that USA, like United States of America, the free world and all of that, I never knew that they were not as open-minded as we thought they were. The third thing I realized from the election and the results and everything is that everybody wants change. Like I remember when APC came to Nigeria and we were saying APC change this, that. The truth about it is some people voted for Donald Trump because they believe that the status quo is not exceptional and that it's not working for them. Obamacare is not good, taxes is not good, this is not good, health is not good. So they want what? change, and to believe that we Nigerians actually see whatever is going on abroad as the yardstick, US or A especially, as the yardstick, as you know what, anything they do is fine. Look at their roads, look at their lives, look at health system. That's what we think. And to believe that people that are from there believe that it's not good and they want change, it just shows that change is the most constant thing in life, and that everybody wants change, everybody wants a new feeling of a new thing is good. That's why people tell you that their marriages are boring or something. They just want a new feeling of something. Everybody wants a new feeling of something. If Donald Trump is there for 2 years, and people say, no, we want another person, nobody's ever satisfying enough. That's another thing I'm chipping in. If you're not, nobody can ever satisfy you 100%. Everybody wants change. Number four is that celebrities are not demigods. Like, who would have thought that if you invite Beyonce and Jay-Z to your program that nobody's gonna vote for you? Huh? Beyonce, Jay-Z, Lady Gaga. I can't even believe it. I used to think, you know, the way you watch Beyonce shows or B.I.'s, the way B.I. just go crazy all up in your social media space. And the way everybody's just, oh, you know, the way they cry, faint, do tattoo of the celebrity, they can kill themselves for the celebrity, do makeup to look like the celebrity, everything. To believe that after all of that, anything they are coming out of their mouth about election, you don't still believe it. These people, Americans, are killing me. They are killing me. Like, they are killing me. Number five is that failure is constant in life and it's going to be painful every time it happens. So just in life, in case you're going through anything and you are failing again, and you are feeling that it's only you, it's my brother, it's not only you, like clinging to your fail. Like clinging as big as she is, she have what? Failure in life. That's the point. I know. Accept it like that. So whatever you're going through, if you fail, just know that failure is constant, it's going to be painful, and that you should just pick up yourself and move on, because it's going to be painful. You know, what was that word? I'm thinking about it. Don't even worry about it. Like something that you cannot change. There's no need worrying yourself about it. Yeah, something like that. So know that failure is constant and it's painful. It like it was pain. You need to watch her speech. It was like, it was unbelievable. Even Obama was like, joke. You get so. Anytime anything you're going through in life, just know that failure is constant. If it happens to you, pick up yourself, brush yourself up, and what? Keep on moving. Thank you so much for watching. I'm still DKM. Sorry about the lightning. Sorry about. See, I just had to do this video. It's like late in the night. Dark. Anyways, thank you for watching. Please subscribe, please like, please share. And I still remain DTD, ETDK, ETDMI, DKM. Bye bye.